Hello, today I'm going to show you how to create this letterpress effect. Here is the color group I will be using today. Be sure the background color is a little lighter than the color of your text. Also, choose darker colors for shadows and lighter for highlights. Select the colors and then click on the new color group icon from the swatches panel. Click OK. Your colors should appear in the swatches panel. If you wish, you can change their order. Next, press the letter M for the rectangle tool. Click on the color swatch that you wish to use for your background and draw a rectangle to cover the artboard. Then, lock this layer. Select the Type tool and choose one of the bold fonts. Then, type your text. Switch to the Selection tool and make sure your text is selected. Next, we will add many effects to our text using the Appearance panel. Be sure that the text is still selected and the fill and the stroke are set to none. Then open the Appearance panel. If the panel is missing, go to Window and select Appearance. Now click on the Add New Fill icon from the bottom. This automatically adds a black fill layer and places it on top. Now click on the color box to open the swatches and choose the color for the text. With the layer selected, we will add an effect. Click on the Add New Effect icon from the bottom. Then choose Stylize and Inner Glow. Let's make some changes. Select the color box and move the slider a little bit up. Change the mode to soft light, the opacity to about 75%. Make sure the blur is set to the edge. Next, highlight the number in the blur window and using the up or down arrow keys on your keyboard, adjust the value to your personal preference. You can always come back here and make any changes later on. Next, we'll add a shadow layer. Before doing this, make sure you click away on an empty space to deselect everything. Now click on the Add New Fill icon. Let's change the color to our selected shadow color. Right now, the shadow layer is in front of our text and we cannot see the text. To change this, click on this top layer and drag it below the text layer. If we turn off the text layer, you will notice the shadow layer just below it. Next, we would like to move the shadow a little bit up to create this effect. To do this, we will add another effect. Click on the Add New Effect icon, but this time select Distort and Transform and choose Transform. To move the shadow up, highlight the vertical move value and use the down or up arrow key to adjust its position. Finally, we will add highlights. First, make sure everything is deselected and then click on the Add New Fill icon. And like previously, our layer was placed on top. Let's change the color to our highlights color. Now bring it to the bottom. Make sure it is selected. And this time we will move it down. Select Add New Effect icon. And like before, choose Distort and Transform. Transform. Highlight the vertical move value and like before use the arrow keys to adjust the position. If you ever need to change anything, open the Appearance panel again, choose the effect you would like to change, and adjust it. After we create our new graphic style, it is a good idea to save it for future use. First, open the Graphic Styles window, and then drag your design into it. Now, for example, we can type another word. Make sure it is selected. Open the Graphic Styles window and click on the same graphic style we've created. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.